So guys, in this video we are going to learn about trusses and how to analyze trusses in FEM. So trusses are engineering structures that are composed only two force members, example bridges, roof structures. For applying the FEM, we have some assumption. First one is ideal truss members are connected only at their ends. Ideal truss members are connected by frictionless pins, no movement. The truss structure is loaded only at the pins. Now, FEM analysis schemes. So we have some steps, but you don't have to see these steps. I will tell you in the question how to solve. So yeah, you can see this step number 4, because we know the formula of K, stiffness is equal to EA by L. Now this one is the simplest question in trusses. In this question, find this stresses in two bar assembly loaded as shown below. So here we are providing the value of E, area is 2A, area is A for this part, and for element area is 2A, length is L for both, and at center they are applying forces or pressure. Now we have to find out the stresses in this rod. So here we can write it like that, as a spring, and here the K value is 2EA by L for element 1, and K2 for element 2 is equal to EA by L, and the displacement is D1X, D2X, D3X for point 1, 2 and 3. Now we have to make the stiffness matrix. We already learned how to make a stiffness matrix, so we can simply make stiffness matrix for that. If you don't know, then please comment, I will tell you how to do that. Now after making stiffness matrix, as we know, the point 1 and 3 are fixed, so value of d1x and d3x should be 0, and if this value is 0, then first row and first column we can assume as 0, and third row and third column as 0, then we will get only value of k1 plus k2, d2x and f2x. So simply we can calculate d2x like that, d1x is equal to 0 is equal to d3x, because there is no displacement, because these points are fixed, and f2x is equal to p is already provided in this question. So we can simply calculate d2x as f2x by k1 plus k2 is equal to PL by 3EA. So we calculated this value d2x. So now we have to firstly find out the strain in element 1. So strain, as we know, the change in dimension by original dimension. So d1x value is 0 here, so we have to put the value of d2x. Then we will get this equation, strain in element 1 P by 3EA. Now we can simply find the stress. Stress is equal to E into strain. So we can put the value of strain here. Now we will get the stress in element 1 as P by 3EA. Similarly for second element, we can find the strain and stresses. Now let's see this example. Here there is a bar which is placed at angle 30 degree. E value is already provided in this question, and area is 2 inch per inch square, and length 16 inch, and the theta angle 30 degree. So we have to find out the stiffness matrix for this. As you know, if we see the length in x direction of this bar, then we'll get L cos theta. If we want to see the length in y direction, then we will get L sin theta, So for that, we make it like that. As you can see, L is equal to cos 30, and we can assume it like that. In the x direction, L cos 30, and in y direction sin 30. So now we know the value of k is equal to EA by L, and we can make this matrix like that, L square LM minus L square minus LM, and then we will take MY LM. You can remember this matrix such that we have to only put the values and we will get the stiffness matrix. So this one is the simplest. You can remember it because we have to remember only half triangle, because if we know the half triangle, then we can put all of the these values. Now see this question. This one is a different question. Here there are two bars, 1 2 and 2 3, 1 2 and 2 3, and they are provided E value and the cross section of the bar, and they are applying to forces P1 and P2 8.2, and 0.1 and 0.3 are fixed, and the angle of bar element 1 is 45 degrees centigrade degree from horizontal axis. So we have to find out d2x and d2y and the stresses in each bar. So let's see how to find this. For that, as we know, there are two element, element 1 and element 2. In this question, there are only two elements, and every element have two nodes, node 1 and node 2, node 2 and node 3 for element 2. And after this, after that, we have to make and for element 1 and 2, length is LL, and the L value is cos 45 for element 1, and M value for element 1 is sin 45, and for element 2, L value is minus cos 45, and sin value is, and element 2, M value is sin 45. We are making this because we will easily find out what are the lengths and what is the value of L and M, so that we can directly put in our equation. So now for element 1, we know the value of K, how to find out the K, and as we know, K is equal to EA by L, and the matrix L square LM minus L square minus LM, as I said in previous question. Now we can put all of the values for element 1 and we will get the value of K1. For element 2, similarly, we can find out the value of K2. Now after that, we have to assemble the global stiffness matrix. We can find out easily. As you can see, we are making d1x, d1y, d2x and d3x, d3y, d1x, d2x. Now see how to find out the global stiffness matrix. For element 1, for first element in global stiffness matrix, there is d1x, the value of column, and the row value d1x. So we can see d1x and d1x from these equations. We'll get d1x as here and d1x is here, but here there is no d1x and d1x. So we can put the value of d1x and d1x from the element 1, L square. Like that, we can make the global stiffness matrix you don't understood how to make global stiffness matrix, then please comment. Then after that, the final set of equation is kd is equal to f. This one is the stiffness equation. We have to put all of these values and we will get the d2x and d1y. Oh sorry, d2x and d2y, because d1x d1y value is 0 because they are, these points are fixed, and similarly d3x d3y 0 because these points are fixed. Now we have to put values and we will get d2x and d2y because forces are already provided in this question, p1y and p2y at point 2. So now we can solve d2x and d2y as p1l by ea and p2l by ea after putting all of these values. Now obtain stress in the elements. For element 1, we can find out stress as e by l, and now as you can see, minus 1 by root 2, minus 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2, 1 by root 2. How you we will get these values? So remember, the formula of stresses in trusses, stress is equal to E by L minus L minus Lm. This one is the formula, and you have to put all of these values in this equation for finding out the stresses. Now we can calculate the stresses in element 1. Similarly for element 2, you can find out like that. The value of stresses is equal to E by L 1 by root 2 minus 1 by root 2 minus 1 by root 2 and 1 by root 2, and d3x and d3y value is 0, and we know the value of d2x and d2y we can put here, and we will get this equation p1 minus p2 by a under root 2. So this one, so this is all about how to solve the how to analyze trusses in finite element method. So if you want this PPT, you can find out the link in description and you can download these PPTs if you want. If anything you don't understood, please tell me and you can comment, then I will tell you how to exactly do and how to solve these numericals. And if you want to solve MCQ problems based on FEM, then please comment, I will provide you a link, and you can see the link in description for solving MCQs, multiple choice question, or you can directly visit roboujala.com, roboujala.com. There are a lot of MCQ questions you can solve.